Opinions. We all have them. I think pineapple on pizza is great. You might hate it. I shit in urinals for convenience. You might call that unhygienic. I think Cinnamon Toast Crunch is the greatest cereal of all time. You might disagree, and you'd be wrong. But I don't think I've ever played a game that divided opinion quite like Kingdom Come Deliverance. Including my own opinion. Sometimes when I'm playing this game, I want to get down on one knee and propose to Warhorse Studios. Other times, I really just want to backhand it. It's kind of like every domestic relationship in the 60s. Nothing displays those emotions quite like this video, so let's get back into the shoes of old matey Henry. You guys have more than likely heard me talk about Opera GX before, but today I'm going to show you the quickest way to import all of your settings from another browser and make your transition to Opera as seamless as possible. Just click here on Settings on the left-hand side and scroll down until you see Synchronization, and here you can import all of your bookmarks, settings, select your previous browser here, and click Import. It really is that simple. Oh, you need your extensions, you say? Well, just click here on Extensions, and then on Get More Extensions, and you want to install this slinky little number here called Install Chrome Extensions, and simply visit the Chrome Web Store, and here you can download anything you had before, like Google Translate, click Add to Opera, boom. It's in Opera. Opera GX is a version of the Opera browser specifically made for gamers, and it is also available on your mobile device, which you can link to your desktop version to make it as seamless of a use as possible. You can download it by clicking the link in the description or the pinned comment below. Thank you, Opera, for sponsoring this video. I go see Sir Radzig, and he tells me about somebody that's been forging fake coin. Of course, Henry gets assigned to go investigate who's doing this, as Henry is following the Batman story arc. First, his parents died, then he learned how to fight, and now he's becoming the world's greatest detective. Anyway, there's a suspect of this fake forged coin being held in a small town of Muirhead, so I hop on my horse and make the journey there. When I arrive, I have no idea whereabouts the hostage is being held, so I go take a wild guess and walk into a random house. It is indeed not the suspect, but I do find a woman grieving her recently dead husband. This is more awkward than when I walked in on my roommates having sex. I tried to break the tension in the air by cracking a joke and asking if I could join in, but they actually said yes, so now I'm in a polyamorous relationship with the two of them, and I don't know how to politely leave. I decide to help this grieving woman by moving her husband for her, as lifting up a limp, full-grown male is no easy task. She, however, takes this in the wrong light and runs off to alert the town guard. Here I am trying to integrate myself in this community, but I'm being shunned for my generous actions. Round two, and this time I'll think twice before I go around touching corpses without consent. I instead start asking questions about this random hostage they have tied up somewhere in this town, but all anyone tells me about is how everyone here is sick and dying. Brilliant. There's a deadly sickness spreading, and I haven't even brought my mask with me. After more investigating, I do eventually find the guard who's holding the hostage, but apparently no one's allowed inside to see him. I really don't have the energy for this today, as I've already died once, and I'm now anxious I might get the sniffles and drop dead once again, so I head to bed. By bed, I mean this bench in a random person's house who has the sickness that's killing everyone, so I'm sure they have bigger things to be concerned about than a stranger sleeping in their home. Definitely not the best nights of sleep I've ever had, but this is the 1400s, and we didn't have Tempur mattresses with a 30-day sleep guarantee back then. To thank the woman for her hospitality, when I wake up I knock her out, and then steal her bread and vegetables, because I need a big breakfast to fuel a big day. I continue questioning the town, but this one lad called Straw doesn't take too kindly to me just walking in his house, so we start fist fighting. I guess maybe he's got some built-up internal demons being released here, because his parents called him Straw. I handle him with ease and fold his body like a Motorola flip phone. I then steal his belongings, but the big baby regains consciousness and tells on me. What a bitch. So the only way I'm going to be able to talk to this hostage is if I get some help for the town and find out what this sickness is. RPG quest design is literally just, yeah, we have a problem, help us fix it and we'll tell you some info. Okay, this info, here's the info. Go here, help this person. If you help them, they'll tell you some more info. Okay, once you've helped them and they've told you more info, go here, go to this person and they'll tell you some more info. So I make my way to the closest city of Sasau in order to see if anyone will be kind enough to help me out. I find some dudes dressed in all black, and no, they're not medieval goths, just smashing out monsters, they're actually medicine experts, so instead of monsters, they smash out alchemy recipes. The main man is called Brother Nicodemus, and although all I can think is his name sounds like a pun, like Nicodemus nuts across your face, he actually agrees to help us once I tell him the symptoms of everyone in the town. He needs a few days, because obviously this isn't the modern age, where he can't just Google the symptoms and get an answer right away. You know, I'm actually fully convinced that old age medicine was literally just a guessing game. They just grab a few different herbs, mash them together in some boiling water, sacrifice a goat, and then feed it to whoever was ill and hope that they'd get better. So while waiting for answers on what this sickness is, I decide to entertain myself by climbing to the top of this church. Up here I find a wooden beam and attempt to walk in a straight line like I've just been pulled over for the police and they're testing how sober I am. I've never actually had to do that myself, but I watched my dad do it many times as a kid. and much like him, I fail to walk in a straight line. The next day, Brother D's Nuts has got some answers for me, and it turns out it's the plague. Not great news for the town, but luckily Brother knows how to whip up a cure. I politely offer to make the cure instead, despite having literally zero alchemy knowledge, expecting him to say no. For some reason though, he agrees to this. I can't help feeling like this was a really irresponsible decision on his part. Offering to help someone you have no clue how to help is called having manners, but it's the last time I'll ever do that, as I'm way out of my depth here. The fate of an entire town rests on my shoulders and my ability to make a cure. I attempt to wing it and put a bunch of herbs in boiling water, but to no one's surprise, it doesn't work out. I try to read the recipe, and my dumbass thought this was some sort of European language I didn't recognize, to only then realize it's actually jumbled English, because Henry is illiterate. Eventually, the whole situation just got a bit too stressful, so I call in on my girl Teresa. Yes, many people may die from the plague while I'm visiting Teresa, but what this shows is actually what a great guy I am. I'm here making so many sacrifices just to be with her. With it being a while since I've seen Teresa, I know I'm gonna have to impress her. There's only one way I know how to do that, and it's by being forklift certified. Unfortunately, forklifts did not exist in the 1400s, so the next best thing is jewelry. I give her my dead ex's ring, and Teresa is over the moon about it. She's flattered, as she thinks I bought it just for her. Little does she know. We head to the pub in the city and chow down on some food which is honestly pretty average. But at least we have good ale. A man old enough to be Teresa's dad, but not in the same way we want her to call us dad, then comes over and starts aggressively hitting on her. Luckily for Teresa, I've been watching a lot of Andrew Tate recently, and he's told me to stand up and defend her honor. He also says I'm not a real man if I continue to use those essential oils in the bath, but having smooth skin is something I'm not willing to sacrifice. I completely embarrass this guy in front of everyone. It's not a great showing for him, as a couple years ago I actually fought a 9-year-old and it took me longer to knock him out than it did to knock out this dude at the tavern. The cutscene then shows Teresa soothing the cuts and bruises on my face, which I'm not sure how I got because he didn't lay a glove on me. Damn, a woman bathing my battle scars with Johnson & Johnson sensitive skin lotion. Andrew Tate will surely kick me off his course if he sees this. I walk Teresa home after a great evening, and we end it all with a kiss. Not gonna lie, after defending her honor like that, I was expecting something more, like an over the garments handy, but hey, I guess we'll take a kiss for now. This was the last time I felt relaxed while playing this game. From here on out, I was just purely stressed. I attempt to make the plague cure again, but fail. I then run out of ingredients, so I fast travel to a dude selling herbs, but when I fast travel in this game, you have a chance of running into bandits, and I do that continuously. I keep running into bandits. If it's just one or two guys, that's fine, I can handle that. Give me it all, pound me. I mean, what? But fighting multiple people in this game is like fighting for gay rights in the Middle East. I'm lost, I've kind of given up on all hope of making this cure. I wait for days in the town to see if Brother Nicodemus will take any action. But no, this man literally just stands in the same spot, surrounded by people dying of a plague that he can easily cure. Obviously, you're seeing condensed footage, but I was literally playing for hours and hours trying to figure out a way around making this cure, but you have to do it to progress the story. I finally cave in and look at a YouTube tutorial, and the dude on the tutorial was Indian, so I knew I was in the right place. Let's fucking go! Did it! I mean, I had to look at a YouTube tutorial, but I fucking did it! I was so ready to give up on this game. I was so ready to just never play this game again. Finally, I have the sweet nectar. As tempting as it is to drink it in front of the townsfolk for all the trouble they've put me through, I give it to Brother Nicodemus, and now we can finally question the hostage. Of course, I get no actual answers, because this is Kingdom Come Deliverance after all, and he sends me on another bait trail leading to a camp where apparently a red knight has more answers. Quest design on this game is like fishing for 10 hours in the freezing cold, watching as your float doesn't even move. But when it eventually does, you finally get a nibble after this long, something is there, you reel it in, and it's a Walker's crisp packet. So anyway, in this other camp, when I'm questioning a guy who was just trying to get a solid 8 hours of sleep, the Red Knight turns up. I chase him on my horse, and luckily for me, he's a dumb NPC that follows a predetermined path, so I just cut him off. We fight, but there's no hope for me, as my sword literally does not penetrate his armor. To put that into layman terms, I have a wooden sword, and he has diamond armor. This fight is more embarrassing than logging into my Tinder profile. I mean, not only is he actually physically harming me, with every time he lands a blow, he's hurling an insult at me, so I'm getting emotional damage too. After dying many times, I realized that after a while, you can just let him escape and meet him at a tavern later in Sasao. A much better, less violent way of solving the situation. He asked me to meet him under a nearby tree, and finally, we're able to have a polite conversation rather than just fighting. However, when I get to the tree, he just says I must die and starts fighting me again. This man got so bored of whooping me in the same location, he decided to switch things up, lure me to a romantic spot under a tree, and cripple my hope right here. I was getting so sick of this German knight and his moustache. I mean, not because he was German or anything, it was the 1400s, they hadn't done anything wrong yet. I realise I'm never going to beat this Chad in a fair fight, so I plan another way to take him out. I wait for him to grab a cold beer and let his guard down, so I can sneak in from behind and stab him in the neck. Getting molested by my uncle wasn't the happiest moment in my life, but it sure did teach me how to sneak up on someone from behind. I take everything he had on his body, including that diamond armor, which means if we're using Minecraft as a comparison again, I should now have at least 15 bitches. The knight also had some important papers about this forged coin, so I return to Scalitz to give it to someone who can actually read. Once this is done, I have to return to Sasao where I killed the German knight, but upon my return, the town's guard isn't too happy with me because, you know, I killed someone and left him outside a tavern. I accept my punishment and take a prison sentence of 7 days, which seems extremely short for a very serious crime. Is this what it feels like to be famous and go to prison? The day of my release comes and I'm determined to be a new man. 10 minutes later, I realize I need supplies, so I find a cute little camp and kill both of the people, then proceed to steal all of their valuables. The Forge Coin questline leads me down many paths, including saving a young woman who'd been captured by bandits and getting into a fight that lasted 15 minutes. I admire Kingdom Come Deliverance for trying to stick with realism, but combat encounters that last longer than I do in the bedroom is just not it for me, Chief. I finally find the source of the forged coin, and it turns out a dude working in a mineshaft is up to no good. The game expects you to take this as an epic battle where you tear down leagues of bandits on your way to arresting this guy, but I save myself from that 700 hours of extra gameplay and just kind of sprinted past everyone until I activated a cutscene and they could do nothing about it. I for once actually win a combat encounter that's part of the game's story, and finally, I've reached the bottom of this forged coin mystery. I love this game, I genuinely do. When it's good, it's so good. But when it's bad, it's so, so bad. Thank you guys for watching. I love you all, and a big thank you as always to those of you who have clicked the join button and become a member of the channel. It really does mean a lot, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye-bye. A big thank you to my Motherload Roy Boys and above, Bjorn van den Hatter, Zyfin, TechTTV, and AWO Theed Smith Loadmaster.